The United Nations, the Section 2 of the plan gives an overview of the United Nations efforts and notes that close to 700 UNGA and our 100 UNGSC resolution have not brought about peace. The plan says the critical recommendations are disputed both as their meaning and legal effects and have enabled political leaders to avoid addressing the complexities of the conflict rather than the allowing a realistic path to peace. Of these resolutions, Debusing says that they have affirmed the Palestinian right to self-determination, that territory claimed by Palestine is under belligerent occupation, that Israeli settlements are illegal, and for that part, the annexation of the East Jerusalem was illegal. And Debusian also stated that the Israel is under the air obligation to withdraw from the territories it occupied, that all states in the region have a right to secure and recognize border, and that Palestinians who become refugees during the conflicts have rights of return of their fair compensation. Section 21 of the plan stipulates that a final agreement will be proposed in a new United Nations Security Council resolution and a new United Nations General Assembly resolution. Present position: Palestine has been recognized as state by 138 United Nations member and has had the status of the United Nations non-member observer state since 2012. Israel, the United Nations state, and most Western countries do not recognize Palestine as a state. The state nation used the term Palestine, state of the Palestine, occupied Palestinian territory, OPT or OPT. The interchangeable dependence on the context. Specifically, the term occupied Palestinian territory refers as a whole to the geographical area of the Palestinian territory occupied by Israel since 1967. Reference to the land or territory refers to land claimed by the state of Palestine. Debusian asserts that United Nations resolution established all the principles that should guide the resolution of the Israel-Palestinian conflict and that the Trump plan does not apply or even mention any of these principles, differing instead to Israel's security concern and the recognition of its valid legal and historical claims. Nicholas Maldino, the United Nations Special Coordinator for the Middle East Peace Process since 2015, pointed out the dangers inherent in the current situation, stating there is no Middle East peace process. U.S. policy change and development of the plan. Development of the plan began in November 2017, led by the Kushner Chief Negotiator Jason Greenblatt, Deputy National Security Advisor Dina Powell, and Ambassador David Fredman. Kushner, a property developer married to a Trump's daughter Ivanka, had no prior experience of the diplomacy, asked the parties not to talk about history, and reportedly never discuss his plan with the Palestinians, according to the Peter Binard of Jewish Currents. Another key participant in drafting the proposal was David Fredman, who became Trump's ambassador to Israel after representing his bankrupt casinos, and he reportedly had close ties to the Israel settler in the occupied West Bank, compared Jewish American critics of Israel to collaborators with the Nazis, and was skeptical about the ideas of the that Palestinians should have a state. In December 2017, Trump recognized Jerusalem as Israel's capital. A key member of the Trump team, the Arabist Dina Powell, left the team on good terms two days after the announcement. The move was condemned by Arab countries, and Palestinians broke off contract with the Trump administration, though maintaining intelligence cooperation with the CIA. Trump reacted by the ending both his bilateral aid for Palestinians and contribution for UNRWA, exiting with the PA's refusal to take part in the administration peace initiative. The United States also shut down the Palestinian diplomatic office in Washington.